South St. Paul. They take the game extremely seriously down there, folks. And next year, they'll be celebrating the 50th anniversary with brand new uniforms.
I'm amazed that they haven't won a state championship.
Haven't won.
I've seen them here so often. I started doing this tournament back in 1964, and I think they've been here every year I've been here. But it's amazing. They've had some real good teams, but they've just had some tough luck. A few games where they would have won. And now we see the White Bear Bears coming out here, a young team. Team surprised a lot of people, got through some very tough competition to get here, especially Hill Murray, that was rated number one for much of the year. But they got here with that, and then they beat Roseville in a fine game at Mariucci, 2-1.
What was interesting is they finished fifth in the Twin City Suburban East Conference. They were seeded fifth going into the section, and it just surprised a lot of people. South St. Paul, on the other hand, finished second in the St. Paul Suburban Conference behind only Park Cottage Grove, and they were seeded number two in advancing to this point today.
And we're looking at Brad Musta, the goaltender for the Packers, very highly touted goaltender, just a 2.03 goals against average. And he's a fellow that South St. Paul's got a great deal of confidence in, and feel that he can propel him through this tournament.
Three-year vet as well, and down at the other end of the rink will be goaltender Landon Luther, who you spoke a little bit about.
Well, his goals against is 3.76, not as good as Musta's, but I have to tell you, he played very well in his last two wins. In Roseville, a 2-1 game, he was a star in that game. He had a lot of quality chances that he had to make saves on, and he's a key person for White Bear, because there's no doubt he's going to get tested quite a bit today by South St. Paul.
They were saying he had a lot of superstitions that Coach Mike Schwartz found about afterwards by reading him in the paper, but he tried all the tricks in the playoffs, you know, the food and the underwear, kind of the things you did, socks, candles. I don't know, he might have had a voodoo doll or something hanging around as well, but whatever works, works.
Well, at least he's nearly not as bad as Tom Reed. Tom Reed, every time he'd hear the national anthem, he figured he'd have a bad game. Well, we're looking at Mike Schwartz over there. I'm certain that he's very happy to be here. I know it's quite unexpected when you look at where he was and seeded fifth coming through a tough competition like he did, but to be here, he's got to be real pleased with the kind of play his team has given him.
Very likable person too.
Yeah,
teaches physical education on both the White Bear campuses.
Very fine coach.
Fourth year at White Bear, and he's been in the tournament three times. Not too bad.
It's a pretty good record, especially in that conference where he came out of.
All right, let's go downstairs once again to PA announcer Dick Stanford and meet the cheerleaders and contestants for today's game.
Final game of the day featuring the South St. Paul Packers and the White Bear Lake Bears. To begin our introductions, let's meet the cheerleaders from the respective schools. First, the South St. Paul cheerleaders. Jessica Wagner. Genesee Kaiser. Sarah Babbitt. Mandy Schultz.
Go back.
Christy Ross.
My mom and dad.
And mascots Tammy Johnson.
I'm playing basketball.
And Sarah Steichen. And now let's meet the White Bear Lake cheerleaders. First, Nancy Guizala. Allison Malik. Tricia Wynn. Erin Rainford. Nikki Obazinski. And mascot Eric Ness. And now let's meet the Packers with a record of 18-5-2. First junior goaltender, number one, Ryan Phelps. Junior defense, number three, Peter Edlund. Senior defenseman, number five, Ben McClellan. Junior center, number six, Isaac Smith. Junior defense, number seven, Dave Simons. Senior wing, number eight, Clint Nadeau. Sophomore wing, number nine, Tony Sylvester. Senior center, number 10, David Bunk. Senior center, number 11, Jesse Winkle. Senior wing, number 12, Ryan Herda. Junior defenseman, number 14, Louis Ramirez. Senior wing, number 15, Chris Johnson. Senior wing, number 16, Mike Simons. Senior center, number 17, Dave Marcotte. Senior wing, number 18, Brian Bodsberg. Sophomore defense, number 19, Tim Horst. Junior defenseman, number 22, Matt Karstenbrock. Junior wing, number 25, Bob Benbow. Senior defenseman, number 27, Brian Hogan. Senior goaltender, number 29, Brad Musta. The head coach of the Packers is Bill Moore and his assistant, Jeff Legault. And now the champions of Section 3AA with a record of 10-14-1, the Bears from White Bear Lake. In goal, number one, junior Landon Luther. Senior forward, number two, Joe Conan. Sophomore forward, number three, Tim Olson. Senior defense, number four, Luke Simonson. Sophomore defenseman, number five, Joe Dustin. Sophomore forward, number six, Paul Thomas. Senior forward, number seven, Jeff Rose. Junior forward, number eight, Richard Klawitter. Freshman forward, number nine, Sean Rode. Junior forward, number 10, Adam Will. Senior defenseman, number 11, Eric Larson. Sophomore forward, number 12, Brendan Connolly. Senior defense, number 14, Andrew Reinhardt. Senior forward, number 15, Jay Guerin. Sophomore forward, number 16, Jesse Turnbull. Senior forward, number 17, Mike Nelson. Senior forward, number 18, Jake Klawitter. Junior forward, number 19, Jeff Payne. Sophomore forward, number 20, Tony Lawrence. Senior goaltender, number 30, David Niewolny. Bears head coach is Mike Schwartz, and his assistant is Stan Blum. And now, ladies and gentlemen, the reading of the sportsmanship code, representing the Packers, Ryan Herda. And representing the Bears from White Bear Lake, reader Jeff Rose.
Good afternoon. Welcome to the Minnesota State High School League Hockey State Tournament. We appreciate your attendance at this tournament and hope you enjoy it.
The state hockey tournament is being played under the rules of the Minnesota State School League. The rules provide for fair play, good sportsmanship among players and coaches. As athletes, we ask that spectators promote the ideals of good sportsmanship, fair play, and respect the opponents and calls of the officials. Thank you.
Thank you, gentlemen. Here are your officials for this quarterfinal game. The linesman is Paul Kwiatkowski, and the referees are Bill Mason
and Mike Riley. The due diligence is done for today's game, and we're ready to go for quarterfinal game number two in Class AA competition. Looking forward to this game. A couple surprise teams here, as we've mentioned previously. Should be for a very interesting contest. The winner from this game will go on to meet the Edina Hornets in our first semifinal game tomorrow night. Earlier today, Simley High School defeated Detroit Lakes 2-1 in a Class A consolation game. And the consolation championship, championship will be between Duluth Central and Simley at 10 a.m. Saturday at Mariucci Arena in Minneapolis. The Bears, he's got a nice mask, eh?
He got a nice uniform. Landon Luther, the goaltender for the Bears, a junior. He's got a 3.76 goals against average. You know, some strong play in the regional playoffs. He had a couple of key games, both Hill Murray and Roseville. He came up with great performances to propel his team here against that team, the South St. Paul Packers, who should be favored today with an 18-5-2 record. An outstanding goaltender, Brad Musta, got a 2.03 goals against average.
Two more games will start tonight, beginning at 7 o'clock. Number one ranked Duluth East will take on Blaine. And in the nightcap, surprise, Alexandria, ranked number six, will take on number three ranked Apple Valley. Should be two very good hockey games. And I know, like everybody else, Louie, can't wait to see Duluth East.
Well, they're a treat to watch the way they play, and there's a couple of good teams in that bracket. It should be an interesting evening tonight and tomorrow night, and I'm certain that everybody feels that Duluth East has got to be the favorite going into the tournament, and if there's a next favorite, it'll have to be Apple Valley. So they'll be the two favorites in the game tonight. We'll see if they're able to move on. As we said so often, anything can happen in a one-game playoff, but those two are the favorites right now at the outset of this tournament.
And I think the biggest challenge for Apple Valley and Duluth East will be not to look ahead. One game at a time. We're underway from the opening faceoff. This is number nine, Road, for White Bear Lake, losing the puck at center. Packers coming right back. Long shot by Nadeau is wide. Goes back and behind the goal of Luther. Pitching in from his defense post is Min McClellan of South St. Paul to keep the play alive. Here's Jeff Rose of White Bear. Cross ice pass, glances off the skate of Brandon Connolly. Packers trying to come back. Connolly, or Rose rather, takes the puck. He's number seven for White Bear. Flips it to center. And we have an offside called, so we'll bring it back to where the pass originated from.
South St. Paul's got a good-looking young defenseman. He's only a sophomore, number 19, Tim Horst. He's got 19 goals and 19 assists. That's some pretty high credentials for a sophomore in this league. And he's a fellow that South St. Paul will rely on a lot to not only move that puck out, but to create some offense.
Luis Ramirez has the puck now for South St. Paul. Banking it off the boards into the zone. Lost it. Here's a shot right on goal. And Luther stops a breakaway effort in the first minute of the game.
Quite a chance that was, because in all alone was Sylvester. He stole that pass. went right to the doorstep, and the fine save by Luther. First save of the afternoon, and it was a quality one for South St. Paul.
Sylvester to Johnson, pass doesn't click. Puck is steered wide by Brad Musta with a White Bear Lake skater right in front of the goal. And back now come the Packers of South St. Paul. Poked deep into the zone by number 14, Louis Ramirez. Back at center ice, Packers get it once again. Just lob it in, going with a dump and chase tactic. Here's Joe Dustin, cousin of the Minnesota Gophers, Bobby Dustin. Joe Conan backhands it to the blue line, picks it up and lets it go, but it's an offside. And we'll spot the draw in the neutral zone.
I got a hunch, Wally, we're going to see a lot of good scoring opportunities here this afternoon. These teams are not afraid to take chances. They move with the puck, and even the defensemen, they move up into the play quickly. So we should see a couple of real good scoring chances in this game, and especially right at the outset as people are just a little more nervous with the puck and easier for turnovers.
Packers trying to enter the zone. Puck is cleared out to center. Rose going after, or make that Joe Conan going after it. He actually rotates with forward or defenseman Jeff Rose for the faceoffs, which I thought kind of interesting, especially neutral zone.
That's right. Yeah, you don't normally see defensemen going into take faceoffs in a neutral zone. You'll have them especially in your own zone where it's really important.
This is Conan battling for the puck. He's number two for White Bear. White Bear Lake wearing the white jerseys with the black and orange trim. South St. Paul has problems clearing it, but apparently they did get it out. Simonson brought it in offside. No score on this one. We've just started game number two of the AA quarterfinals.
Front desk.
If you want to check into this kind of room, with comfort and space for you and your guests and all the luxuries of home, a conversion van from GMC gives you all the pull you need. Now check into a new conversion van and get the added comfort of $1,500 cash back. See your GMC dealer today.
Back to live action. Going after the puck for White Bear Lake is Brendan Connolly. Connolly with Rode and Olsen out there, puts it back onto the point, winding and firing a shot by Eric Larson, hits traffic out in front, tries another drive, and it goes all the way around, and is tipped to center by the Packers. Scooting in after it now is Ryan Herta. Here's Herta, going behind the net, trying to wrap it around, and the goalkeeper, Landon Luther, is there to cover up, and Herta lost control at the last second.
Well, Herta came around and tried to just jam it in. He didn't see Nadeau coming right up the middle. Watch as Herta goes around, see if he can pick up number eight in a slot area, coming up the middle, and he was behind everybody. He'll come into the picture after this. He's about 10 feet right out in the middle. If he'd have been seen, he had a great scoring opportunity with everybody back around the net. So St. Paul forwards got to look up a little bit and just move that puck. Many times you get close to the net, you get anxious. You try and just jam it in or force it in, and you take chances or shots that aren't really good angle shots, and you could look up and have a good outlook for a good scoring opportunity.
White Bear Lake on the attack. Here's Mike Nelson going from the right to the left and taking a shot wide. It's picked off the boards by Tim Horst, a very good and promising sophomore defenseman for South St. Paul. Joe Conan in his own end. Make that Jeff Rose, number seven for White Bear. He's it across to his defense partner, Simonson. The relay effort to center was intercepted and apparently came out despite a few oohs from a crowd.
Yeah, that was a good play by Horst. He thought he had kept it in, even though he was outside the zone. The puck hadn't come out, and he had a stick across the line and knocked it down out of the air. Good hand-eye coordination picking those pucks out of the air like that.
Got a quick glance of Jeff Legault, the assistant coach for South St. Paul, and another offside called here. We have had a lot of that in the first 4 minutes of this game.
Yep, we've seen a few more of these offsides right now than we've seen in the last two games, the one this afternoon, the one last night. Just a little anxiety, I think. Players not looking to see if they're offside or not. Sometimes you've got to be more disciplined. Even though you think you're open, you can't cross that line until you're getting the pass here. and it's going to be coming your way. You're going to let the puck carrier do what he wants to do with it.
Eric Larson for White Bear. His dad is a JV coach. Now, I don't think that should have been an offside. Apparently, they're going to call it. So, still a scoreless opening period for the St. Paul Civic Center. We'll be back. Right back to the live action as the Packers play it down to Bear Country. Nice check thrown down there by number 16, Mike Simons, to break it loose for South St. Paul. They chase after it now to the far side. Still some scrambling going on. Simons trying to kick it loose. Blocked by the Bears. And here's Will at center ice with it. Leaves a trailer for his defenseman, Joe Dustin, and clears it inside the South St. Paul blue line. Now skating back is Peter Edlin for South St. Paul. Around for Louis Ramirez. Headmans the pass, and the Packers roll out of their own end. Down the left side is number 16, Simon. Still to the ice behind the pack, Bears' goal. Adam Will coming back. His brother played on this team last year for White Bear when they're at the tourney. South St. Paul's Clint Nadeau into the zone. One hand on the stick. He centers it. Heard a shot blocked. Another effort. And Landon Luther hugs the post and the puck.
Luther played that perfectly. He just stayed real tight to the pipe. He knew that the shooter had no place to go, and he just was hugging the pipe, not allowing him to come close as Simmons was trying to knock it in on the short side. And look at Luther. He's just going to be right close against the pipe. Goal stick down, really no area for the Packer to put that in the net.
Bonk with the puck for the Packers. Try to get a pass to Huerta. It's intercepted. Now Huerta, number 12, has it. He then loses to Jeff Rose. It popped out in front. And finally corralled by Quawitter. Packers get it again. Fired out in front and just out of the reach of Huerta. Turns and shoots. It's tipped just wide by Bonk. On the far side, Luke Simonson for South St. Paul. Keeps things, actually White Bear Lake, now to Rose, who wheels it around to the other door. And they're content here just to take an icing call, with South St. Paul applying some first period pressure. The Menards scoreboard shows no tallies to this point, and the first period will continue from the state capitol.
Being a parent means getting the most for your money. Introducing the 96 Lumina. For a lot less than Ford Taurus GL, you get 24-hour roadside assistance, a bumper-to-bumper limited warranty, and now you can get a great lease payment on a well-equipped Lumina. You see, we've worried about everything, so you don't have to. The 1996 Lumina, a car your family can trust.
Test drive one today at your Heartland Chevrolet Geo dealers.
South St. Paul putting on some pressure on White Bear, out shooting him 4-1, but still not able to get any real good quality chances. They tried a couple of jam-ins, but that's the only opportunities they have.
Brian Hogan, number 27 for South St. Paul, pokes the puck off to the corner away from Mike Nelson. Nelson checked, tries to roll in for it. Now here's Nelson behind the goal for White Bear. Over to Turnbull. He missed controlling it, and it's scooped up now by Chris Johnson of South St. Paul. Stabbed off of his stick. To the other side. A bank pass off the board by Jesse Winkle. It's stuck in some skates. Not finding it was Peter Edlin. The Bears get it in center. Nobody home. Here's Tony Sylvester for South St. Paul. He's crunched into the boards by Tony Lawrence. And the Packers now come up the right side. Jesse Winkle, number 11, takes a wrist shot. Pad save. Winkle gets it again, puts it in front. It's off the skates of Johnson. Shot from the point now goes wide, and pinching in with Peter Edlin with the drive.
Oh, had Winkle made a good pass to Johnson there, that would have been just a glorious chance. He was in perfect position, 12 feet right in front of the net, and the pass was just inside the scoop.
Right below our camera was Mike Simons, number 16, as he shoots it in. Backboard is Rose, number 7. He's popped and flattened on a hard jolt behind his own goal by Simons. The Bears roar out. Two against two. down the left side, trying to work it out in front is Connolly, and he's crushed into the end boards by Ben McClellan. Body contact really picking up.
Both McClellan. Of these clubs not afraid to use their body, Wally. You're right. A lot of good hitting going on out there.
A big crush right in front of the South St. Paul bench. Neither player moved. Bears bring it in, but it's an offside. It's a little premature with Joe Conan on the left side.
Well, South St. Paul defense, McClellan and Horst stood that play right up, and that's what they had to do. They didn't allow Conan to get over that line and just force the offside, but both of these clubs taking the body, not afraid to mix it up, and you're going to see a lot of physical play the rest of the way.
Back wide of the South St. Paul goal. Goes around to the other side for Ramirez. Lost control, picked up now by number five, Dustin, trying to put it in front. He does. A slow wobbler from the point is wide of the net and helped out behind the goal. Now here's Edlund. A little bit of a hook, but he pokes it up ice on a neat play. But standing up very well in the neutral zone was Dustin for White Bear. Eric Larson behind his goal over to Joe Dustin. Pass is right into the skates of a South St. Paul player. Dustin whacking at it one more time and helps it out to Olson, who relays to center. Packers shoot in. It's offside, but everybody tags up, so the play is legal. Larson. His pass to center is intercepted. Trying to cross was Nadeau, but he was tied up. Another big check thrown down there by Peter Edlund, and there are White Bear Lake people falling all over the place. Nadeau right back. He's checked, trying to release the shot, and back comes Joe Dustin with a pass across ice that carries into the Packer end.
White Bear having a tough time completing their passes. They're making good plays, but when they get control of the puck, they're not making good passes to get out of the zone at all.
Luke Simonson's rising shot goes over the net from center ice. It's driven right back in by Jeff Rose. Second on the team in assists and third in points. Rose is a defenseman. Now bringing loose is Jesse Winkle, but he is robbed at the blue line. Puck still hangs there. Hops over Winkle's skate, or stick rather. Here's Rose trying to go up ice for White Bear, but no luck. Driven in now by Jesse Turnbull. South St. Paul works it right back. Up the middle is Winkle. He's slowed down, carrying on, and with a shot is Rod Mossberg. Blocked, and right back is Rose. At the line. Oh. Bounces off a check, and a man had a horse connected. Rose would have been in the first row of seats.
You've got to be careful when you come full speed and cross the middle once you get in the zone. Those are opportunities defensemen live for.
Horst is tripped. Tony Lawrence is guilty. And the game's first power play will develop for South St. Paul. We'll be back to describe it right after this timeout in a scoreless game.
UPN Lions game time coverage of the Minnesota State High School Hockey Tournament is brought to you in part by Dairy Queen and your Vikingland GMC dealers.
You're going to see Tony Lawrence get a tripping penalty right here. His horse is coming up ice. He just reaches out across him, takes his legs out from under him. And the South St. Paul Packers, with 4:32 to go in the first period, will go in the power play, first power play of the afternoon. And the sophomore Lawrence is ready to sit out 2 minutes.
Power play for South St. Paul has been 34% on the year. It's a good power play percentage in high school hockey. They work it to the point. Now across to the left side, and the shot is off the glass and out of play.
Well, Horst fed that puck right across to Edlund. Edlund shot off the pass, but it just seemed like as he received the pass, the puck stood up on its side, and he got that shot right up in the air over the glass, comes outside the zone, and you'll have the face-off there. But South St. Paul, with a good power play like that, you can see that they like to move the puck around and have the fellas on the side shoot right off the pass. And they got a key man, Horst, on the blue line. As he said, a high-scoring defenseman is really the real host of his power play.
They're working the perimeter right now. Peter Edlund, number 3, getting it back to the point, receives a pass, sends it back on the line to Horst. Now to the other side for number 8, Clint Nadeau. Winding up his horse, he scores! Wow, what a cannon!
Now I know why he got 19 goals.
Yep.
That was a great shot. Not only was it hard, it was accurate, it was low. Everything you want from a defenseman, shot on the point, on the net, down low, and hard. And he just puts it right by Luther to give South St. Paul a 1-0 lead. Good shot by Horst as he gets set up there. He takes a look, he sees it open, he got a screen in front. He had players right where he wanted when he got two forwards setting up in front of the net. You want to get that shot through to get a rebound. You're not hoping to score goals. I mean, you hope to score, but you don't think you're going to get them from there. But when you've got a rocket shot like that, you can put them by a goaltender. All you need is just him to be blocked his vision for 1 second, and I think that's what happened to Luther as South St. Paul goes out ahead.
At full strength, White Bear Lake hauled for icing. Horst with the goal, 20th of the year. He was 6th in the St. Paul Conference with points. That's his 10th power play goal of the year.
Well, he set up sort of an umbrella. He's at the top. He's got two in the middle, off to the sides, and two down low. And he worked it perfectly right there.
Adam Will, number 10, getting it up to Jeff Rose, number 7 for White Bear. And then Rose is flattened into the corner boards. Behind the net, Edlin of South St. Paul throws a check. Another big crash just inside the blue line. And throwing the check there was Luke Simonson of White Bear. Back on the attack, here's Adler putting it out in front. But it's steered wide by White Bear defenseman Jeff Payne. Lots of scrambling play right now. The Bears taken back a little bit by that goal. Here's Rose. Dumps it in and heads off for a change. Dustin and Larson will step on defensively. Meanwhile, the puck behind the Packer net. Off the boards comes Johnson, moving up the right side. Tries a sidestep, number 14, Reinhardt, and does. And there's going to be a penalty here for Reinhardt as he slowed Dustin down, coming up through the middle. Power play once more developing for South St. Paul, and they lead 1-0.
Brandy sets off a chain reaction.
You burned a chain letter?
On new Boeing.
Tuesday at 7 on UPN 9.
Andrew Reinhardt going to the penalty box. South St. Paul very effective on their first power play opportunity, getting a 1-0 lead, now getting another power play with 2:39 to go. As we look at the call right here, as the Packer goes outside and he just reaches out and grabs him, pulling him down right there. And you see Johnson going down. Reinhardt gets called for holding, and South St. Paul goes on the power play.
Back after it is Tim Horst, the sophomore. To Edlin, who relays it through the middle. And crossing the line was Herta, but apparently it's offside. I think Nidu was a little bit early.
Herta got just a little too anxious, too. He thought the pass was going to go over the blue line. Just stepped inside. It was a nice outlet pass coming up the ice. South St. Paul looked like they might have a 3-on-2 yep. developing very quickly, and they broke that puck up the ice very well.
Digging in at center is Dave Bonk, number 10 for South St. Paul. These are difficult numbers to read. I really don't care for jerseys with stripes through the middle of them. Clint Nadeau, number 8. To the line, Horst unloads another one, and that's just wide. Bears clear. Horst at center. Rink-wide pass to Nadeau. Horst will go to his defense partner on the right this time, Edlin. Now up through the middle for Herta. Herta entering the zone slowly. Goes down low. Make this Nadeau, number 8. Now to Herta behind the goal, to Bonk, number 10. Back to the point, Horst takes a shot over to Edlin, but he can't get there as Sean Rhodes broke it up. They lift it down ice, just missing Tim Olsen on a breakout. Here's Olsen for the Bears. He's crunched behind the goal, and Horst rolls out of the corner. Straight up the left, cuts to the middle. Horst Lisa Claire, Bach with a shot, but it rises off of a stick and hits down Zamboni Alley.
Well, it was a real nice play. Horse set up Bach. Bach was just a little slow getting that shot off. It looked like Horse was going to shoot. He came down. He sort of faked it, froze his defenseman, and left the pass for Bach. Bach just took a little too long to get away. The defenseman got a stick on it. White Bear sits back. They only have one forechecker going up ice when they throw the puck down, and they're not very aggressive killing the penalty. Bonk stays all the way up to the blue line, and three White Bear players were all the way up there, allowing South St. Paul to come out of their zone very easily. Really no pressure in South St. Paul up ice, and that's been the reason why they're getting in the zone so quickly.
20 seconds remain in the Conker power play. We're in the final minute of the period. Ben McClellan, headman pass to Jesse Winkle. He's dropped to the ice. Getting a loose biscuit now is Mike Nelson for White Bear, and he's rolling it into the zone. McClellan overskates it, stops, finds it. Back up to Winkle. He's checked. White Bear has killed off the penalty now. And it's a 1-0 game with a half minute to go in the first period. Here's a steal. Rolling up ice is Jesse Turnbull, but he overskates the puck. Chris Johnson. Now they give it away. Nelson getting it for White Bear, trying to cut out in front, but it's swept away from him. Here's Dave Marcotte slowly getting it out to center. And the Bears just lift it right back in.
Looks like we're going to have another period with just one shot on goal. White Bear's only got one shot on goal in the first game we had this afternoon. There was only one shot on goal in the first period.
Packers outshoot the Bears 8-1. And a power play goal by Tim Horst stands after the first 15-minute period between South St. Paul and northern suburban neighbor White Bear Lake.
South St. Paul had a great deal of puck possession in White Bear zone. However, they weren't able to complete some little passes. They had some opportunities there right in the slot area, but some errant passes really took away their ability to get some quality chances. They did have three good scoring chances. One they put in the net. Luther had to make two other key saves. Eight total shots for South St. Paul. They had two power plays. Scored on one, and the other one, they only got one shot on net. Defense did a better job on the second one, keeping the South St. Paul Packer forwards away from the net and really putting a little pressure on them, making them turn that puck over a couple of times.
Not a comfortable situation for White Bear Lake to be in when they have trailed after one period of play this season. They are 0-9. Jeff Grayson is standing by downstairs. Let's go to Jeff.
All right, thanks, Wall. I'm with White Bear Lake coach Mike Schwartz. Coach, 1-0. You're down after one. Your thoughts on the first period, what you saw?
Oh, an inexperienced team playing in their first state tournament. Everybody's just throwing a puck to get rid of it right now. And, you know, they're a good team, and they're making the best of their opportunities. We just got to settle down and play our game right now.
Tell you guys to relax, get loose, do you think?
Yeah, I mean, you know, all the young kids, the first thing they said, gee, look at all the people in here. And, you know, they're Bantam things. That's all they ever see. It was just the parents there. Here there's 16,000 people. It's a big adjustment. We just got to get them to relax a little bit and play some hockey.
So, yeah, sometimes a team gets that out of their system, say, after a period. You think that can happen with your guys?
Oh, yeah. It's a big adjustment anytime you come to this building with them young kids. And like I say, it's going to take us a little time to adjust. I just hope it doesn't take too long.
All right, thanks, Mike. Good luck in the second period.
Thank you.
All right, that's Mike Schwartz, the head coach of White Bear Lake. Right now it is 1-0. His Bears trail. Back with more Game Time programming on UPN9, including a news update from Stephanie Odegaard when we come back.
Once again, experts are predicting an easy winter.
For Jeep Cherokee Sport owners anyway, its 190 horsepower engine, four-wheel drive and anti-lock brakes turn even the harshest conditions into a day at the beach. And now get no charge air at a lease rate of just $259 a month. Jeep Cherokee Sport, the perfect way to turn a wild winter into a mild winter.
For the best in automotive sales, service and value, see your local Jeep and Eagle dealer.
If you have children involved in sports, there's only one eyeglass lens they should be wearing. The polycarbonate lens. Look what happens to a standard plastic lens when struck by a projectile. Compare this to a polycarbonate lens. Notice the projectile simply bounced off the polycarbonate lens without breaking it. Be safe and choose polycarbonate lenses for your all-star player. Vision World, Minnesota's locally owned optical company.
Before your next haircut, ask yourself a few quick questions. Is your hair salon open evenings and weekends? Grey Clips is. Does your hair salon clearly post their prices?
$21? Last time it was only $16.
Grey Clips does. Are the stylists at your hair salon courteous and friendly? Are they professionally trained? Do they stand behind their work? If your hair salon is Grey Clips, then you already know the answer. Grey Clips. Guaranteed satisfaction, guaranteed style.
Baseball sure has changed, Junior.
Yeah, the hexagon replaced the diamond.
And can you imagine facing three pitches?
Emerson on base. Oh, the base ejector caught him snoozing. He goes.
Why did it all change?
All sport. Game just got too easy.
The unsurpassed taste of all sport. A third more carbs than Gatorade for energy could make a difference.
Next yeah, up.
Your grandson's up.
Ken Griffey the fourth. He connects. It's going. It's going. Watch out, center field. Oh!
Center field got him.
He was robbed.
All sport body quencher. The game will never be the same.
This is a Minnesota 9 News Update.
Hello, everyone. I'm Stephanie Odegaard. Here are the stories making news this hour. Two workers at Delco Roofing in Plymouth are recovering after a close call with dangerous fumes. The men were rushed to the hospital after they fainted while cleaning an asphalt tanker. A Minneapolis police officer is in the hospital with a broken leg after falling nearly 30 feet from a parking garage. Officer Alan Williams was wrestling with a suspect when he went over the edge. That suspect is now in custody. And the Wilmer School District is under fire for discrimination. Parents representing 850 students are suing, claiming racial bias against Hispanics. Stay with us. We'll bring you some more news at the end of the next period. We'll see you then.
Cold temperatures across the state will continue. We'll see you again next hour with another weather update.
Got to come up big for plans this weekend? Then check out the weekend calendar, Thursdays, on Minnesota's most convenient newscast. We'll help you out. You know, like Julie on the lift boat.
Yeah. Your life is nuts. Pizza delivery is your idea of a dream sequence. Have we got a newscast for you?
Yeah.
What is the one thing that could make your life a little bit easier tonight? Okay, we'll throw in the babysitter too.
Edina awaits the winner of our second Class AA quarterfinal on Class AA quarterfinal Thursday. Sault Ste. Paul with a 1-0 lead over White Bear Lake. You heard White Bear Lake coach Mike Schwartz say, hey, he's got a young team. He came in playing in front of a huge audience. Think there might have been some jitters, which is bound to happen. We'll see what happens in the second period. But all our games so far, including yesterday's Class AA game, no real blowouts except for possibly the War Road Detroit Lakes game, which ended up 6-0, but that was gradual. No one really got out of the gate quick against another team, so we're seeing some very competitive hockey. Still just a 1-0 game. The Packers with a lead over White Bear Lake. We're back with more, including Wally Shaver and Lou Nanny's analysis of the first period when we come back.
Dairy Queen has been filling my head with all kinds of new Blizzard and Breeze flavors. What do you think about thick, chunky fudge Oreo, crunchy cappuccino heat, or creamy mint M&Ms at $1.69? Ooh. And how about those other Blizzard and Breeze flavors, all starting at $1.69? I can't wait to dig in. But first things first, for hot eats, cool treats, think DQ.
Power up your workshop with dazzling deals from Menards. Save on a wide selection of air compressors from Campbell Hausfeld. A one-horsepower model is $174. Air tools are also on sale. Add style and security with lock sets from Schlage. Flare passage locks are on sale for $16.47. Entry handle set $68.95. Menards is your place for Schlage lock sets.
Save big money at Menards.
Being a parent means getting the most for your money. Introducing the 96 Lumina. For a lot less than Ford Taurus GL, you get 24-hour roadside assistance, a bumper-to-bumper limited warranty, and now you can get a great lease payment on a well-equipped Lumina. You see, we've worried about everything, so you don't have to. The 1996 Lumina, a car your family can trust.
Test drive one today at your Heartland Chevrolet Geo dealers.
The Thompsons got their home equity installment loan from First Bank, not just because they could finance their car and deduct the interest, or get convenient ways to manage their money, or pay for the new addition to their home. They chose First Bank because the bank loaned them 100% of the equity in their home, which let them consolidate their finances and their family all at once.
For special rates and no closing costs, apply by phone today.
South St. Paul showing their dominance in the opening period of play over the White Bear Lake Lakers. They got one goal out of the period, but very much in control, Louie, as we saw them work the puck quite well in that first period.
Yes, they certainly had the majority of puck possession in that period. They did get one goal on the power play. Overall, I'd have to say the power play, the key is that Horst. You look at Nadeau, he comes up the boards, he finds Horst right in the middle. Horst takes a look, he sees two men in front. He makes just a great shot down low. Luther had no chance on that. And the key is to get your people screening the goaltender, working in front of the net so that you're bothering the goaltender, and then get a good shot on the net. Horst does that. He's got 20 goals now, and it was a nice pass by Nadeau. He laid it out there perfectly. Many times after that, you saw where South St. Paul had good puck position in the zone. They had people in scoring areas, but they made errant passes. You want to put that puck on the tape, and that's what Nadeau did to Horst. And he made no mistake about it, and that gives South St. Paul the 1-0 lead they have now, even though they had opportunities to get more than the one that they have on the board.
Putting the puck on the tape worked, too, because they controlled the play for South St. Paul and led to a lot of shots on goals. They outgunned White Bear Lake 8-1 in that opening period of play. Could be a cold game for goaltender Brad Musta down there in the South St. Paul goal. He hasn't seen a lot of action his way. We'll see what White Bear Lake can do to adjust here for our second period coming up next.
The Paranormal Borderline, Tuesday at 8 on UPN 9.
What's the best way to get into America's best-selling car? Get 4.8% financing and get it on any 96 Ford Taurus. It's the Great Percent Event, direct from Ford Credit to you. 4.8 financing for 48 months on Ford Taurus. Or choose 600 cash back on a purchase or 600 back on a red carpet lease. Which means with just 10% down, you can lease a new Taurus for just $269 a month for 24 months. It's the Great Percent Event. So get into your local Northland Ford dealer and get into Ford Taurus today.
Baseball sure has changed, Junior.
Yeah, the hexagon replaced the diamond.
And can you imagine facing three pitches?
Emerson on base. Oh, the base ejector got him snoozing. He goes sailing.
Why did it all change?
All sport. Game just got too easy.
The unsurpassed taste of all sport. A third more carbs than Gatorade for energy could make a difference.
Next up,
your grandson's up.
Ken Griffey the fourth. He connects. It's going. It's going. Watch out, Centerbrook. Oh!
Centerbrook got him.
He was robbed.
All sport body quencher. The game will never be the same.
Because someday you'll get that big promotion that moves you to Seattle. Someday kids will be in the picture. And someday you'll get away to write the great American novel. It'll happen. That's why we've spent 28 years constantly improving the Corolla. So wherever life takes you, we'll be there. The newly restyled Toyota Corolla. We're looking forward to tomorrow.
Bob was not about to pay a delivery charge on his new refrigerator.
He should have gone to Warner Stallion for free Metro delivery. Plus, save now on Amana, GE, KitchenAid, Maytag, and Whirlpool appliances. 0% financing, builders and remodelers packages available now. If we've got it, it's on sale.
Warner Stallion, where you get professional installation, free recycling, and always free Metro delivery.
Should have gone to Warner Stallion.
South St. Paul leads White Bear Lake after one period of play in our second Class AA quarterfinal. Jeff Grayson back at the Civic Center. And you know what time it is, don't you? It's Toyota time. This is the seventh consecutive year that Toyota and your local Toyota dealer have sponsored the Toyota School Spirit Competition. A winning school will be chosen live during the Class AA championship game on Saturday night. And that school wins the use of a 1996 Previa van for a year. Again, this year, entries have been collected from high schools around the state. And one of the 12 finalists is Moorhead High School from Newark, New Jersey. No, they're from Moorhead. You know that. I'm trying to lighten up, will you? Doug Price is the principal at Moorhead, and they'll be one of the 12 schools in the drawing on Saturday night. Let's get right to some sensible talk. Wally and Lou, take it away. Okay, thanks, Jeff. Our GMC Vikingland cam gives you a perspective. 16,934 here for the afternoon attendance and this first session of AA quarterfinal hockey.
Two games yet to come tonight. Duluth East will play Blaine and Alexandria and Apple Valley in the nightcap. If you missed the first one, the Edina Hornets advanced by beating Rochester John Marshall 2-1 in a very thrilling third period of play between those two teams. But these two right now have struggled a little bit here in the early going of the game, and particularly White Bear Lake just had a very tough time getting anything mustered at all, Louis.
Well, Mike Schwartz is right. He's got a very young team, and can you imagine being a freshman or sophomore coming into a building like this where you got so many thousands of people here for the first time you played in front of a crowd like that? It makes you a little nervous, and he's hopeful that his team's going to settle down and play a little better in the second period here.
South St. Paul with the puck and the lead as they center it at the flex and heads on out of play. White Bear Lake has 10 seniors, 4 juniors, 6 sophomores, and a freshman on their squad. South St. Paul a little more experienced with 11 seniors, 7 juniors, and 2 sophomores.
And the sophomores and freshmen for White Bear Lake get a lot of playing time. They're key players. As we said, in the first two lines, the 6 of them, they got 4 sophomores, 1 freshman.
South St. Paul has now gone 10 straight periods without allowing a goal against.
That's pretty impressive.
Here is Tim Horst, who has the game's lone goal on the power play. Chugging up the right side, trying to cut in. Oh, and it's swept away at the last moment by Jeff Rose. Otherwise, he was in home free.
That was a good move back to your forehand. That's a tough move for someone to make. And he always had it home.
Here's Rose, putting it into the slot, and Brad Musta. Yep, I think that's probably the first time we've mentioned his name today. Pounces on it.
Rose likes to move up from the defense. He skates well. He's a fellow that obviously was moved from forward at one time because he likes to handle that puck. He moves up on a play quite well. Plays a lot for White Bear Lake, and he's got 7 goals this season, which is real good for a defenseman. He's definitely the most noticeable puck-carrying defenseman at White Bear Lake's got.
Off the draw, South St. Paul has it to the left of their goal. It's number 14, Louis Ramirez. Got another Louis around here. There's Louis. Passing to his defense partner, Edlund. Looking for room. The pass a little bit off target, intended for Tony Sylvester. At center, falling to the ice is Ramirez. And the Bears shoot it inside the St. Paul zone. Packers trying to come up. Passing, not real sharp right now. From center ice, Eric Larson drives it in. Gloved by Musta. And he makes a wise choice in keeping that puck contained in his glove. Clarity, scoreboard, shows a 1-0 game on a power play goal at 11:11 of the opening period for the Packers.
Being a parent means getting the most for your money. Introducing the 96 Lumina. For a lot less than Ford Taurus GL, you get 24-hour roadside assistance, a bumper-to-bumper limited warranty, and now you can get a great lease payment on a well-equipped Lumina. You see, we've worried about everything, so you don't have to. The 1996 Lumina, a car your family can trust.
Test drive one today at your Heartland Chevrolet Geo dealers.
Claw winner for White Bear, wanting to win that draw, and he does. Right back there, Cohen just missed on a good shot. That's what you got to do when you get those offensive opportunities. Put him right back in the scoring area and let him get a shot on net.
Joe Conan, he's an alternate on the third line, shooting it in for White Bear Lake. They've had 2 shots on goal this game. A blast from the point by Simonson rises wide, and back in neutral ice is Jay Guerin. Guerin's pass is poked out to center ice. Trying to cut across the line is Turnbull, but he's decked to the ice. Make that Jake Clawwinner. He's wearing 18. He's alone out in front. But his teammate, Guerin, can't get it to him. Through the middle come the Packers. Across the line is number 11, Jesse Winkle. Dropped to the ice. Fans howling for a penalty, but no call. On the far side is Ryan Herta, number 12, sending it behind the net. Now Herta gets the pass, has a man out in front, it's back to the point, Horst shoots, it's right on and blocked by Luther.
And he's the one that you want to have the puck right there, Horst. He was just 15 feet away.
Here we go, the great chance, moving in his balls, and his shot is wide. As they caught White Bear Lake on the chain. Back the other way, Tim Olsen. Oh, and a beautiful defensive effort by Horst. Stop Olsen. Here's Klawitter. Richard Klawitter dropped to the ice. Eric Larson clears it in for White Bear. And end-to-end action opens things up a little bit.
So St. Paul almost got caught in that line change. Rode looked like he had a breakaway, but a good play by Horst to come back and take the puck away from him.
Lots of action along the boards there. A little punching going on by Tim Olsen trying to free it loose.
A penalty there,
and that's going to cost Olsen as a penalty is being called. We'll be back for the power play with 11 and a half minutes remaining in period number two.
Broadleaf and corn, section four.
Control to Clarity. Engage.
No other herbicide battles broadleaf weeds like Clarity. It attacks at multiple sites so weeds can't build up a resistance.
Clarity to control, red alert. We have a resistant combo burn.
No problem.
I register no more broadleaves.
All resistance has been crushed.
Clarity, a higher standard of broadleaf control.
You're going to see Tim Horst cross-check right along the boards. This is going to give White Bear Lake their first power play opportunity. You see number three, Olsen, taking his man down, and now they start to play. We could have shown it, but Horst is going for two, and White Bear Lake trailing by one on the power play, their first power play opportunity of the afternoon.
White Bears power play, 21% on the year, 1-for-9 so far in the playoffs. Here's Larson. Pass is stopped at the Packer blue line. Collision of players. White Bear carries on and sets it up behind the goal. With the puck is 17, Nelson. Puts it onto the stick now of Lawrence. Back to the point. Taking a shot and making the pass is Dustin. The shot comes on with a scramble.
It is.
They score!
Larson right in front of the net gets Dustin's rebound and just put it away. Good puck movement by White Bear Lake. They got a shot from the far side off the pass. It looked like a bad angle shot, but the shot was on a net, which is a key. That created a rebound. Dustin gets a first shot. Larson on the doorstep finds a loose puck. Here's a shot from the blue line, or from the side, right on the net. You see the rebound line right there, number 11. Larson puts it away. Good puck movement.
Well, I thought I heard a whistle, Louie.
I didn't hear it. There was no one in the crease. The puck was lying free.
Yep.
Conley had the first attempt from the short side. The rebound went right to Larson. So Conley should get an assist on that goal as well.
Nelson and Guerin are credited with the assist. And it's tied just like that. Two power plays, two power play goals, one by his club.
Get a penalty and you make them pay, and that's what happened here this afternoon. Each of the clubs getting a power play goal. Muska, who really didn't have much opportunity to make any saves before that, had only two shots on goal before the power play. Now there's four. In fact, if one shot this period was from outside the zone, he had a whistle because of it, but he had to make the save, and then he had two point blank shots. The second one went right in. Loose puck right in the doorstep. Larson put it home.
Olsen right back on the attack for White Bear. Has a shot on goal. He led the team in an assist in points this year. From center ice. Shot right back in by Luke Simonson. Four goals on the year. All of them came on the power play. Puck is tipped around by Brian Hogan. Picked up off the wall by Matt Karstenbrock. His pass is tipped. On the far side after it, number 12, Connolly for White Bear. Headmans it up ice. Trying to reach through the zone is Olsen. He's pushed into the end boards now by Hogan. Johnson starts back. South St. Paul changing on the go. White Bear Lake rounding their net. Simonson lifts it high into the air. It'll carry all the way down, and icing is whistled against the Bears.
Well, that goal by White Bear has really given them some life and has certainly given them some confidence. They're moving with a great deal more ease. They seem like they want the puck a lot more than they did earlier in the game. And right now they got South St. Paul back on their heels. South St. Paul hasn't had much opportunity to do anything with the puck for the last 5 minutes. Well, White Bear Lake here coming out with some fine play, good forechecking, knocking them off the puck. And the only opportunities the Packers had in the last minute nullified by some bad passing coming up through the neutral zone.
Here's Tim Horst. Played a lot of forward hockey as a youth, put back on the blue line, and has done remarkably well there. Tony Sylvester leaves a trailer, trying to cut through some traffic as Chris Johnson for South St. Paul, but a sprawling effort by Mike Nelson breaks it up for the Bears. Horst with some good lateral speed over to Dustin. Excuse me, make that McClellan, and we have an offside called against White Bears. It's a 1-1 game. We'll be back to the St. Paul Civic Center for more state high school hockey.
It has the highest ground clearance in its class. But more importantly, 1996's Pickup Truck of the Year comes with 190 horses. All with big chips on their shoulders. Toyota Tacoma. You simply can't buy a more powerful compact truck.
White Bear having a much better period. Position-wise, they look a lot better. They're staying on the puck. They're quicker, more aggressive in their forecheck than they were in that first period.
Musta stopping that long-range shot and not trying to play any chances with that one.
Even though White Bear hasn't had a great deal of opportunity to handle the puck in South St. Paul's zone, they're starting to create some turnovers down in that zone. And they're not getting any shots yet from in close, but they're playing with a lot more confidence, and it's got to give them a lot more assuredness when they're handling the puck in the zone as well.
Absolutely, you can see that. White Bear continuing to apply some pressure, but the Packers break it out of their own zone. Number 8 is Clint Nadeau, the captain. Bumped to center by Rose of White Bear. Hogan plays it back to his defense partner. And the puck skips out of play. Slowing it down, you think it's an advantage for St. Paul now?
No, I think that they're back on their heels a little bit. I'm sure their coach is not very pleased. Bill Moore is not going to be pleased with the way they're handling the puck or moving the puck. It just seems like they can't gain control of White Bear's zone at all. I'll bet in the last 5 minutes we haven't seen them down in there for more than 10 seconds at all. They're having a great deal of problem coming out of their own zone and even in the neutral zone making any passes.
Just had a shot of the White Bear bench with Coach Mike Schwartz. You saw him laughing and smiling down there, and I suppose halfway through the game they figure they're happy to be in a tie contest.
Yeah, well, he's got to be happy to see the way his team's reacted this period. They're playing with a great deal more ability than they did in that first period.
Nice skate save there by Landon Luther as he ricochets that one right out to center ice and almost starts his team right back up on the attack.
That was the best save of the game for him. That was a hard shot right on the corner. That was a great skate save by Luther.
Hogan for South St. Paul rings it around to the other side. Lifted now to center by Johnson. Both Herta and Nadeau are trying to gain control. Here is Herta with the puck for South St. Paul. Shoots it in and heads off as they make a complete line change of all five players. White Bear rolling back. Connolly across the line, slowed down by number 17, Dave Markoff. And backboard is McClellan, circling behind his net. McClellan falls with a stick in his skates. No penalty calls. The puck goes out to center. Blasted right back in by Eric Larson.
You know, here we are, Wally, with 6:45 to go in the second period. South St. Paul's only got one shot on net this period.
Again, broken up by Larson. Here's a shot. Oh, just going wide on a nice try there by 25, Bob Benbow. White Bear back.
through the middle. They do some crisscrossing. Wait for everybody to get onside. Carrying on now is Lawrence. He scores!
Oh, what a good effort that was.
Tony Lawrence!
Tony Lawrence, really a key play right at the blue line. You see three White Bear forwards all at the blue line, and one of them had to react quickly to get back onside. Lawrence took it outside, drove to the net, a left-hand shot coming on the right side, so he's on his forehand, and he goes into the net as well as the puck. See right here, right there, he's a good play to stay onside, and look at Lawrence drive to the net. He puts the puck in and himself as well, goes right into the net. And White Bear Lake taking their first lead of the afternoon on a strong play by Tony Lawrence. Real smart heads-up hockey by Nelson and Turnbull to stay onside there.
They've got to be just living a dream down there in White Bear Lake. They're not supposed to be here, folks. If there was ever an underdog in this tournament, it's the White Bear Lake Bears. They now lead 2-1. We're past the midway point of this period, and we'll be back to see if this Cinderella story can continue.
On the world premiere of The Paranormal Borderline, see footage of an actual Yeti. Star Trek's Jonathan Frakes hosts.
Tuesday at 8 on UPN 9.
White Bear continuing their amazing play through the regionals and now thus far in the state tournament as they take a 2-1 lead and a good effort by Tony Lawrence. There's 6 minutes to go here in the second period.
And a lot of different combinations being thrown together by White Bear head coach Mike Schwartz. They're not afraid to try things. Hey, they're not supposed to be here.
That's right. And he gave Sosia Paul, that was a shot on net from way out on the goal. Harmless shot, that's only the second shot of the period.
Jeff Rose, the senior, rings it around. It carries back into the South St. Paul zone, and this is Dave Simon's backcourt. Simon banks it around. The South St. Paul now having a lot of problems, Louie, trying to make that first pass out of their zone.
They really are, Wally. They haven't been able to connect all period long, and that's what's given them problems they've had this period.
Simonson can't get it away from two forecheckers, but a second effort does, but it'll be an icing call against White Bear Lake.
You know what happens? First of all, you're not playing well. Then all of a sudden you lose the lead. Then you start getting tense, and you don't handle the puck nearly as well as you should. And South St. Paul was already having problems passing the puck. Now they've had a great deal of difficulty making any kind of plays. We've seen a lot of scrappy play here by both teams, and that's playing into the hand of White Bear right now. They've got the lead, and they're content to make certain that there's no quality chances. They'll dump the puck. They'll just get it out of the zone any way they can.
Horst, the setup man at the point for South St. Paul, has a shot go wide. It's back in behind the Bears' goal. Cranked around to the weak side by Sean Rode. Not out. Packers trying to get something developed. Number 8 is Nadeau. This is the big line for South St. Paul. Nadeau puts it in front. There's a shot right on goal by Herta. And that's blocked by Luther. And the Bears again take an icing call.
And that's the best play that South St. Paul's had in the offensive zone all afternoon. That was a real good opportunity. A good pass. And Nadeau centered that puck right out, only to have that shot stopped. Landon Luther, who made another big save on that play. Really a quality shot by Herta after a nice setup by Nadeau. Here's a work in the corner. Nadeau coming out right out to Herta, who's in a perfect scoring area. He went to the short side. Luther down low got it with his pad and made the save. That's the best chance South St. Paul's had all afternoon if he didn't score.
Herta drops it to the point for Horst. Shot is stopped in traffic, and the Bears come out 3-on-2. Across the line is Nelson, cutting to the left. Still has it. The shot is right on the crease. And sprawled out is Brad Musta to make the save.
And Musta had to fall on that rebound because the White Bear forward right on the doorstep, had he left that rebound on the ice, you could have had another goal like that in the power play. Tony Lawrence is standing right in front of him.
There's the team manager, Louie. His name is Chip Steensland. He's 6'7", 400 pounds. But he's just a great kid. All the teammates just love this guy. I guess they every time they go to the rink for practice, they have to walk by the Steensland residence. And Chip's mom usually has a bunch of cookies there for the guys. So he brings them on down. And brilliant kid, though. He's number 10 in the class. and a big part of this team in more ways than one. Here we go with the attack coming into the White Bear Lake zone, and Landon Luther is going to pin it up for a faceoff. We're going to take a short pause here and come back to the St. Paul Civic Center for more quarterfinal hockey.
One thing South St. Paul hasn't done this period as well as they did in the first is take the body. They were more physical in the first period, and they seem to be in the play more. Right now, they seem to be reaching for pucks when they're checking rather than taking the body, and that's not helping them nearly as much as their physical play did in the first period.
The Bears with a 2-1 lead. A pass for Larson. By Larson, goes up for Adam Will. And he relays it into the South St. Paul zone where Peter Edlin has it. Rings it around for Hogan. His headman pass is picked off by number 15, Guerin. Guerin set up that last goal. His effort is stopped. And it rolls back to neutral ice. Poke checked away by Bob Benbow. A lot of bees in that, boy. Benbow behind the goal. Takes a pass, leaves it loose in front. There's a shot by number 17, Marcotte. And Luther looked like he had a little bit of a problem with that one, but he does make the save.
It actually looked like Luther was expecting a harder shot, and Marcotte didn't get a lot on it. It just seemed to flow towards him. Watch as that shot comes. Puck gets centered right over to him right here, and it seemed like he was trying to get more on it and almost looked like Luther overextended himself, and the puck wasn't even there yet. Just about handicapped him, but right in front of the net, Larson took his man down and made sure that he couldn't get any rebounds. Luther was able to freeze the puck.
2-1, White Bear Lake leading. The winner of this game will be playing Edina tomorrow night at 7 o'clock. It sent it out in front, even though the South St. Paul player had been totally tied up. And Luther has to be sharp once more, and it looks like the tide beginning to change a tad.
Well, South St. Paul is starting to come on now, and that was a good play. Even though you can't get your stick on it, get your foot on it. And it seems to me that's what Winkle did there. He kicked that puck over and almost had a scoring opportunity for his lineman. But South St. Paul putting more pressure on the offensive zone in the last minute.
Horst has to hustle back. Winkle chops at it. So does Connolly, and it ends up back in the South St. Paul end. Horst takes it from his defense partner, McClellan. Fires it across ice to the weak side. To Sylvester. A delayed offside, but everybody touches up, so nothing called. But here comes White Bear Lake back on the rush. This is Tim Olson, and his shot rises over top the goal. Olson behind the net trying to go for it. Pushing it away is Johnson for South St. Paul. At the point, kept alive by Rose. Rose for White Bear, one hand on his stick. Musta comes out. And a wise idea there to freeze it.
Looked like Musta wanted to poke check that puck away. Didn't quite get all of it, and the puck just laid there for a second. White Bear with a player right in front of the net. Almost got control of that. Good effort by Rose driving to the net to create that confusion at first. As we said, he's a defenseman who likes to move up in the play. He's real quick off the mark, and he gets into that play, he can cause some problems for South St. Paul.
Behind the net. Turnbull for White Bear, number 16, had it momentarily. Poke checked away from him. Packers get it up. Throw a pass in the middle. Now look for the breakaway, and it just misses Ryan Herta. Bonk has it, number 10. Here's Bonk, passing it across to Nato. Oh, back to Herta. He just missed as he was camped at the edge of the crease.
Nice play by Bonk, and a great shot by Nato off the pass.
Here's Bonk again, back to the point. Winding and firing is Edlin right on goal. And Luther comes up with another save.
On the top line for South St. Paul. Put on a little exhibition there, passing the puck, shooting off the pass, and some quickness, and that's what they hadn't been doing thus far. Any of the lines of either team have that sharp passing, as we saw there from Bonk to Herta. Really a pretty play to that line, and almost cashed in to tie this game as White Bear Lake holding on to a 2-1 lead with 1:23 to go. And South St. Paul taking over the play the last 3 minutes of this period.
Luther again freezes it. The White Bear Lake team had been alternating goaltenders, Luther and Dave Nowalny, all season long until the stretch and the playoffs. And Luther was given the number one challenge, and it's obviously paid off dividends for his team. Simonson for White Bear, and they go up the middle to Olsen, who falls, bounces right back to his skates, but he's all slowed down by Edwin all the way back up ice.
Olsen's had a good period here for White Bear Lake. He's really quick, and he's got a great to shoot that puck. Dangerous forward for him.
Rose for White Bear. One hand, pokes it but not out. A long shot from the point by Ramirez is wide. Now it's tossed back to the far side. Herta to Bonk, looking for Nadeau in front. Doesn't click. Bonk squashed into the boards. Nadeau rolls in for the puck. Back to the point for Edlund. His shot is stick wide by the goalkeeper Luther. Moving in from the point is Ramirez to keep it alive. South St. Paul, good control now. Nadeau, this is their top line out there. Puts it in front for Bonk, but he is all tied up. And White Bear Lake starts back with 12 seconds left. Nice defensive play, though. Stops the momentum at the blue line. And that will pretty well do it for the second period of play. As White Bear Lake overcomes a 1-0 deficit after the first 15-minute session, ties it up on a power play in the second and adds one more to take a surprising lead.
And White Bear Lake got the lead for a minute there. It seemed like they had a great deal of confidence, played very well. Then all of a sudden, things changed. South St. Paul playing their best hockey of the afternoon, had continual pressure on for the last 5 minutes of this period, not able to score any goals. Got 16 shots on net now. And the top line, Bonk, Herta, and Nadeau really putting in some pressure on the
shots on goal in the period. South St. Paul,
it's going to be tough to keep that line off the board.
White Bear Lake, 6 to period, total 7.
White Bear Lake has never won the first game of the tournament. And they are now just 15 minutes away from advancing for the first time ever into the second round. And Mike Schwartz, I'm sure, will just keep things loose in the dressing room. Meanwhile, the Packers have got to find a way to win.
And they've also got to find a way to get the puck out of their zone better than they have.
Absolutely.
I think that's been the biggest weakness they've had here this afternoon. Obviously, it's been passing, but especially any facet of their game that they can improve, it's coming out of their own zone. They haven't come out as a unit very well all afternoon. If they do that, with the kind of pressure they're putting on the offensive zone, it's going to be tough for White Bear to keep them off the board.
Jeff Grayson's downstairs. And Jeff, what are the thoughts going through head coach Bill Moore's mind?
Well, that's what we're about to find out. Coach, second period. I know, Nick, go the way you thought. Your thoughts on the second period and the adjustments you need to make?
Well, the big thing we need to do is we need to start playing better at center ice. We're giving them too many opportunities to break up our attack and then counterattack too quickly. So we've got to either get the puck deep in their zone or we've got to beat their defenseman wide and get it in and get something going on the offense.
End of the period, you kept your guys on the by the bench a little bit before coming off. Did you try to pep them up to get, you know, keep the divers up, so to speak?
Yeah, I guess we just want to make sure they're a little frustrated with, you know, not getting the job done right now, and just let them know that, hey, it's early, it's only one goal, we can go in spurts, we'll be ready.
All right, Coach Moore, we'll let you get inside. Thanks for joining us.
Thank you very much.
All right, that's Bill Moore from South St. Paul. Another great game, 2-1. White Bear Lake, team Cinderella possibly. We still got another period to find out in our Class AA quarterfinal. Back with much more as Game Time on UPN 9 continues. A packed house at the St. Paul Civic Center watching a great Class AA quarterfinal as part of quarterfinal Thursday. White Bear Lake leads South St. Paul 2-1. The winner meets the Edina Hornets tomorrow night in the first AA semifinal, but plenty of hockey left. White Bear Lake, some people say a team of destiny. They've certainly pulled off upsets to get here. They scored two goals in the second period to come back from 1-0. They lead 2-1 as we head to the third period. Coming up, Wally Shaver and Lou Nanny will analyze the first two periods of play. We'll take a look at some of the statistics. All that and more as Game Time on UPN 9 continues.
It's certainly not the prettiest hockey that we have seen so far this year, Louis, or even in this tournament, but Aaron passing has kept the sloppiness equal between these two teams, and we're in a very close hockey game once again for the second double-A quarterfinal game in a row.
Right when it looked like White Bear had no confidence, wasn't playing very well, their coach was concerned, they come out in the second period. It seemed that all of a sudden he started playing more intelligently, forechecking much more aggressively, drawing a penalty. They go in a power play, and we get the first goal for White Bear Lake after some smart play. When we'll roll the tape here and watch the power play, you'll see the White Bear Lake move the puck around real well, and then the key there, shooting off the pass on the net. Rebounds in front. They get one opportunity. Watch the puck line there, and Larson puts it away in an open net. That seemed to give them a spark. After that, they played a little better, and we'll see another goal that White Bear Lake scored through really all individual effort. Tony Lawrence going wide, fighting for that puck, driving to the net. As he drives to the net, he's a left-hand shot, so he's got a good angle, gets it on the far side of the Musta, gets knocked down, and it looked like right there White Bear Lake was going to play better as the period went along. But right after that, Wally, it seems South St. Paul had something click, and they came back and had the best play of the two periods for them.
It's really worked well for White Bear Lake. They storm back and take a 2-1 lead in this game and looking for their first ever first round victory. We'll see if they can do it. We're 15 minutes away.
Morgan Fairchild, Chad Everett, Star Command. Monday at 7 on UPN 9.
Ten of below 500 team advanced to the state semifinals. Bear Lake is going to give it a shot. They're up 2-1 as we go to the third period. And Wally and Lewis, we send it back up to you. I just talked with White Bear Lake coach Mike Schwartz, and he says we have a knack for surviving third period. He likes his team's chances when they lead after two. He says his team has about a 9-1 record after two periods. He got that first period out, kind of worked out some jitters, and he's confident. Back to you guys.
He's got a good reason to be confident right now.
Well, as he said, he's got to feel good about where he is. His team comes out with a real lackluster first period. All of a sudden, it looks like they're going to be out of it. Next thing you know, they get a lead, and South St. Paul comes on, plays better. They survive the last 5 minutes, and now he gets to the third period where they've had so much success this year when they're leading. So he feels pretty good about it, but I think he's going to need that because it looks to me like South St. Paul is finally starting to break out of their lethargy, and it seems like they're going to get some opportunities here in the third period.
That's our view from high up in the press box here at the Civic Center with the Viking Land Cam. The shots on goal in the second period, 8-6 in favor of South St. Paul. They hold a 16-7 shots on goal advantage in the first 30 minutes of this game. And Brad Musta not seeing a lot of action, but two of the seven have gone past him. It's interesting to talk with head coach Bill Moore yesterday. He said after his team was leading in the third period of the last playoff game, they had yet to allow a goal against. But some of the South St. Paul fans, they're so intense, they were complaining about the fact that he was playing defensive hockey. He also said afterwards, he walked into a local pub there, and a 70-year-old man came up to him and said, "Jesus, just win so I can die happy."
Well, you can understand why the fellow feels that way. South St. Paul's been here so many times, you know.
Yeah, it's a long
time. Sure, it's frustrating not to have won the state tournament, but they've had a tremendous record getting here.
27th appearance in 50 years that they've had hockey. And they're still looking for their first state championship. White Bear Lake, Simonson. Out to center, but Horst is there for South St. Paul and bucks it right back into the Bears' end. Headman pass goes to Olson, who's played strong here today. Sean Rode after to the far side, taps it in, but backing up with it is Horst. Throws it up the middle, it eludes everybody. No icing will be called, as it could have been played en route by Jeff Rose. Rose now banks it off the wall, taps to center by Rode. Horst dances back across the line, but is stopped in his tracks. Now from the other side, shot in by Clint Nadeau. Nadeau, along with Herta and goaltender Musta, have played together for 3 years and were in the tournament 2 years ago with South St. Paul. White Bear trying to drive it in off the stick of Tony Lawrence, who has the game-winning goal at this point. Jesse Winkle intercepts a pass, lost it. The Bears get it once more. Stolen by Edlund. Starting up for South St. Paul. He crosses center and relays it in deep. Trying to apply pressure now is Isaac Smith. Bears clear it once again. Ball in the center is Chris Johnson for South St. Paul. Rose lifts it off the glass, takes a favorable bounce to center ice, landing on the stick of Adam Will. He's checked at the blue line. Scooting in for it is Tony Lawrence. It gets past him. Puck control by the Packers. They crisscross at center. Trying to roll into the zone is 19 a horse, but the puck deflects off of the White Bear Lake Bear and into the crowd. 2-1.
The Bears came out the first 2 minutes and got the kind of effort they wanted. Some strong forechecking, keeping the Packers off balance and not giving them anything. That's the way you want to start a period. And you've got that lead and you're in the third period. You want some confidence if you can check them into the ground.
Third line for each club out on the ice right now. Here's Carsten Brock behind the goal. Backhands it, trying to get it over to number 16, Mike Simons. Simons working the wall very well. Falls. Carsten Brock is there. Has a man in front and the tip shot by Marcotte just wide. Marcotte bounces it back to the other side for Mike Simons. Simon rolls it down low. Carsten Brock in to help out. Carsten Brock 22 trying to relay it to the point. Conan is there for White Bear and they clear their own zone. Horst coughs it up. Guerin can't carry on. Puck loose out in front. Here come the Packers, 3-on-2. Up the right side, Mike Simon fires right on. And Landon Luther is key.
And that's the best thing that could have happened to the White Bear Lake Bears. A 3-on-2 and a shot and right at the goaltender where he could hold on. As Carsten Brock got a lot of wood on it, but Luther was smart to hold on to it because he had no help. Right on the doorstep, driving at the net. The Packers, you see him coming out of the zone real good, getting that shot on net, and Luther very wisely held on to it.
Right from the draw, backhand shot by Herta was on target. Not out, shot from the point, there's a loose puck right in the crease. Oh, and another shot hits the side of the goal as Bonk rolled in for the rebound. Then Brian Hogan can't clear it. Look out, dangerous play. But here's Adlin streaming up the middle. Peter Adlin going to the outside, working in, centers it. Bonk fanned on it. And coming right back is Tim Olsen. Olsen handing it off to Sean Rowe, back in front for Olsen. And that just misses. Wow, I like this.
Up and down, two teams each having a chance, just missing at the last second.
The Bears can't clear. Working in his horse. It's blocked by a sprawling defenseman. Herta with a try. At the point, McClellan with a blast. And that's stopped out in front as it hits a pair of legs. And White Bear Lake drives it all the way down.
White Bear Lake getting caught out of position far too often in the last minute and a half. They had three forwards getting caught down deep twice. And this time they had five people all in front of the net. No one's picking up any loose men. You look here, here's an opportunity, but look at the defenseman sprawled in front. When Simonson sprawled, he just blocked the shot, and then everybody's down deep. You see this? All five of them, no one picking up a man. It's just like they can throw a hula hoop around them. And South St. Paul not able to get that puck through. White Bear a little rattled right now.
Peter Edlund now to Winkle trying to cut in, but he's squeezed wide. Winkle has another try with it, looking for Sylvester. Back to the blue line. White Bear taking over. 11 is Larson. Trying to poke it out of the zone. Unable to do so. Larson with another try, but he's checked by the other 11 for South St. Paul, Winkle.
Watch over, let's go!
You hear the referee yelling, move it.
Referees have really done a good job of keeping that puck in play, not allowing anybody to freeze it. They tell them to move it, and they just won't let them freeze the puck. Keep the action going. Larson's third on defense right now for White Bear.
Yes, he is. It comes out in front. Lawrence clears it off ice. Packers turn it right back in. And begin to make a player change as Johnson heads off.
Larson. He wanted to get off. He just fired it all the way down. You could tell he was tired. He wasn't going to wait around. And that was good. He didn't take a whistle. Just put the puck right on the net.
18 is Jake Hawitter for White Bear, but he can't get to it. Rose for the Bears around to his partner Simonson and back to Rose. Sends it around to Adam Will. Gets past him. Tapped by Clawitter to center. Taken by Dave Simons at South St. Paul and relayed right back in. Packers changing much more frequently than the Bears are right now. Spin around by Simonson as he waits. Two players floating towards center ice. Long breakaway pass not working. Dropped back in by Louis Ramirez. A little risky right now for White Bear to try those long bombs, eh?
Very much so, Wally. You've got no help back there for the defenseman. We've got to stay in that zone until they get the puck out. They've got the lead. There's no use being all the way up ice and hoping for a long breakaway pass.
Ryan Herta has a chance, one-on-one against Rose. Long shot through the edge of the crease is off target. Now here's Bont picking up the loose puck, hands it off to Nadeau, centers it through the crease off the goaltender Luther wide. Back is Pete Edlin.
Right now they're right back in their heels. White Bears right back in their heels. They're not coming out at all with that puck, and they're just shooting the puck blindly out of the zone.
Here's a chance. Bont, he scores!
Well, you could pretty well see that coming. There was a lot of pressure being put on White Bear, and White Bear not able to get the puck out. Bonk puts it away, and he really read that play well. And he looked until he had the perfect angle and let that puck go. Some great deal of pressure from South St. Paul for the last 3 minutes, and here you see right in front of that, Bonk getting a rebound, goes wide. He knows the goalie's down and gets it up and away from him. Right after he got that rebound from Nadeau's shot, he just goes wide, uses his head. You see the puck being centered right here, and Bonk's going to come right in your screen right now, going wide and putting it away. Good centering play by Herta. He got it to Nadeau. Nadeau gets the first shot, and Bonk puts it away, and we've got a tie game.
Boy, good chance by Dave Nadeau, and a nice setup by number 12, Herta. Now coming back the other way is number 12, Connolly for White Bear Lake as he plays it behind the net. Olsen trying to get to it. The Packers intercept and try to come right back out. Johnson pokes the center. Winkle relays it in deep. Halfway through the third period, it's a two-all game. South St. Paul is outshot. White Bear Lake 22-8. Here's a long bomb, and that's deflected just wide by Johnson. Johnson roaring out of the corner. Leaves it for Sylvester. Back to Winkle. Turning in the circle. Takes a shot. Luther makes a save, and he'll hold for a faceoff. And South St. Paul is dominating right now. First Bank shows you the score. It's tied up at 2 with 7 minutes to go.
Cold temperatures across the state will continue. We'll see you again next hour with another weather update.
White Bear came out with a good 2 minutes of this period, starting the period. Then the next five has been all South St. Paul. They're shooting them about 7-1, but they certainly have been dominating the play. Strong forechecking and not allowing White Bear any opportunities at all. White Bear actually just seems like they're back on their heels, and they're really looking like they lack confidence right now to handle a puck or do anything with it. And that's playing very diligent in their own zone. They're running around, they're leaving people open, and they're getting caught out of position And with the forecheck of South St. Paul, they just continue to come up with the puck and get some opportunities. You just knew that they were going to score. You could feel that goal coming. The White Bears got to regroup here if they want to advance, because South St. Paul is playing with a great deal more poise at this period of the game.
From the point, Brian Hogan shots on goal. South St. Paul now has outshot White Bear Lake 8-1 in this period. Here's Rose at center, lifting it into the Packers zone. Everybody clears, so the play remains good. Trying to work up ice is Karsten Brock, but he's checked. Carrying on now is number 16, Turnbill, put it out in front. Loose puck grabbed by the Packers and relayed back to neutral ice. Rose to Simonson. To Nelson, too far. Marcotte bangs it off the boards. Back it comes to Bob Benbo. Benbo shot, hits Klawitter's stick. Simonson gathers it up, fakes a shot, sprawling the blocking attempt with Marcotte. Now it comes on goal, and Muster makes his second save of the period. 5:51 to go. There's a pause in the action. The teams will change, and we'll return to downtown St. Paul for more of a tie game. You could win a $3,000 vacation package. Just stop by any First Bank location to ask about First Bank's Fast Line Bill Pay free trial offer and register for the contest. Two grand prize winners will be announced live during our telecast of the boys' basketball championship game. Along with Jeff Grayson, our host, and Lou Nanny, our analyst, this is Wally Shaver from the St. Paul Civic Center in a second of four Class AA quarterfinal hockey games. This one tied up 2-2, and we haven't had a lot of scoring in the AA bracket yet.
No, we haven't, and we're not going to have a lot here tonight, this afternoon either. We're not getting many chances. We would think you'd get more because of the wide openness of the game, but they just don't seem to be connecting on the passes or getting the kind of opportunities you would expect when people are out of position. It just hasn't translated into scoring chances.
South St. Paul starting up from their goal line. A flip pass to center. Oh, a big check at center ice. And a favorable bounce now in the White Bear zone. Back at the point. Here's McClellan with a long shot. Gloved by Luther. And he'll hold that one for another draw. We'll be back to the St. Paul Civic Center for more quarterfinal hockey.
Wally, we've seen the glass on the left side here provide about three different errant bounces. They've got to be careful. White Bear does clearing the puck around that glass, because you think it's coming out of the zone, it's bouncing right back into the middle of the zone. Must be part of it just sitting out of it, you know, a weird angle, and that puck hits it and it just carries right into the center.
South St. Paul trying to set it up behind the goal. It's put out in front. Winkle with a drive, and it's blocked by Luther. And the Bears fire it down ice to take the pressure away.
Oh, what a good save there. Luther had to make a big save on Winkle. A nice play coming up from behind the net. Sylvester and Johnson all down deep. The puck's behind. It comes right out onto Winkle's stick. You see the centering pass right here. And right in the middle, Winkle gets a shot away.
He was in heavy traffic to release that,
yeah,
too, eh?
Yeah, and then he got it away quick, too. Good save by Luther.
Winkle on the faceoff. Back to Horace. He winds and fires, but breaks his stick.
Late almost went in there.
Sylvester working the corner. Good hands as his stick handles away from traffic. Rose goes to the other side to his defense partner, Simonson. Puts the brakes on and spins to the other direction. Loose one in front, look out. Jim Olsen is there to cover up. Now darting across the line is Sean Rode. Trouble progressing, but carrying on is Connolly, putting it in front. Muster with a huge save off of Olsen. Simonson steps up and sends it behind the goal.
Olsen's been a very dangerous forward here for White Bear today, and really got that shot away quick. Rode down in front of the net fighting for position, and he's got real good quickness moving towards the puck. His first few steps are always very fast. He's been very, very dangerous, you know, getting to loose pucks. But the Good save on Olsen right in front of the net. Look at him, number three. He's been dangerous all day when he's in the offensive zone for right there, getting a good chance. Musto having to make a fine save.
Lawrence, Nelson, and Turnbull out for White Bear Lake.
Just when you think they're dead, White Bear Lake, they bounce back and get a good chance.
It's amazing how they just keep going. Yeah. The Cinderella team has not finished the chapter of this book yet. And here they come right back with Nelson leading the charge, cutting to the right, tries to go left, but falls and lost the puck in the process. It's kept in, though. Nelson sends it across ice, too far for Lawrence. Rose steps up from center. Everything's onside. Falling was Lawrence. Here's a shot. Blocked out, a rebound by Turnbull. And he's stopped by Brad Musta at the edge.
Oh, what a great save by Musta, because Turnbull made a nice play, got to the far side, and really had a good shot on the low corner. Good leg save by Musta.
Karsten Brock for South St. Paul gets it up ice. Entering the zone with Marcotte, just shoots it in and heads off for a line change. Rose now feeds it to his right. Poked by Karsten Brock. I'll make that Tony Lawrence. Now McClellan for South St. Paul. Delayed offside is finally stopped, and that will create a pause. We'll be right back here in downtown St. Paul with 2.5 minutes to go in a tie game.
From the network that brings you Star Trek Voyager comes a new generation of heroes.
You're mine now.
Prepare yourself for Star Command. Monday at 7 on UPN 9.
We're getting into one goal territory wins here, Wally. We're down to 2:23 to go in the third period. Tied at 2. And not a lot of time left. One goal right now should win it, whoever gets that goal. So you could expect both of them to be taking every shot on net that they get the opportunity to do.
After now, Eric Larson can't clear it. Packers holding it in. Their top line is out there right now with Herta, Bonk, and Nader. But here comes Olsen roaring back for White Bear. Olsen goes around the net, puts it on the front. Two guys are there. And both Rode and Connolly could not get a shot away.
I think he didn't know where the puck was. It went right into his skates. I'm sure he didn't know it was right down in his skates. Connolly just seemed to look down, and the puck had been centered and hit him on the side, and he couldn't locate the loose puck.
Reinhardt for White Bear tried to clear it, but unable to do so. And coming out in front, here's a shot by Nader, blocked with traffic. Reinhardt, number 14, trying to find it. Nader behind the goal. Back to the point, McClellan partially fanned on it. Puck stays alive. Turning his bonk. Herta after it. Being watched closely by number 11, Larson. Around it comes to the other door. McClellan has it once again. Ben McClellan to the corner. Nadeau working his way to the point. Lost the puck, but he has to be careful with Olsen right on him. Now Herta to McClellan as we enter the final minute of the third. It's put out in front.
I think it was Sylvester or Nadeau. Was Nadeau right on the doorstep. Some strong forechecking by South St. Paul, keeping that puck in, and a good pass out of the corner right in front of the net with 55 seconds to go here in the third period. Nadeau right on the doorstep, and this line has come to life in the late in the second period. Fine pass. You see that right across. Dustin passing, or McClellan passing that puck right across to Nadeau, and he's right on the doorstep. Good play. McClellan moved in to keep the puck in, centers it in front of the net, and Nadeau was all alone and beat Luther, giving South St. Paul a 3-2 lead, 55.6 seconds to go. And this line from South St. Paul has really had the bulk of the scoring chances for them this afternoon, especially since the middle of that second period. Bonk, Herta, and Nadeau have been forechecking aggressively, creating some opportunities, and finally resulted in the last two goals for South St. Paul. Got them in a position to win this game right now.
Nadeau, his 27th goal of the year. McClellan the assist, and what a smart play that was to pinch in. I tell you, those guys really looked like they're at the end of the shift. They were really tired out there.
Right. As a matter of fact, you know, McClellan, before he pinched in, just previous to that, made a good move keeping the puck in, getting the shot through. He played real sound defensively. At the same time, he gambled when he knew he had, you know, better than a 75% chance to get that puck and keep it in, and resulting in the goal for him. Right now, White Bear Lake, of course, is changing the goaltender just to give themselves a rest. They don't want to use a timeout. And so what they do is change the goaltender. Next whistle, they'll probably change back again. This way, they get to keep their top line. The top player is fresh. They watch 55.6 seconds while they search for the tying goal.
It's Dave Nololny being warmed up. The senior goalie, 4.44 goals against average, 4-5 on the year. Coach Schwartz said he will play in the tournament. They had rotated the two goalkeepers all season long until the playoffs when Luther got hot. So more than likely, if White Bear loses, he will play in the consolation game tomorrow.
Well, you could expect White Bear to get that goalie out of here pretty soon. It was looking like overtime. Thought I was going to have to call him and see him come to hold my stake. But right now, South St. Paul with some aggressive checking to keep White Bear out of their zone, even prevent him from pulling that goaltender. That's what they want to do. And we won't have overtime.
What steak?
The one I'm going to eat. Medium, sirloin, medium. Crew wants to know if I'm buying for them, but
I think you should.
Only if they're all coming down there and they can all eat in 35 minutes. You see Mike Schwartz on the bench trying to get everybody in position. He's got his goalie out at the top of the circle. It's a real good move by him in position to dart for that bench so he can get a sixth attacker on. He wants to get the puck in the zone and get a whistle if need be to set up.
Saddle him up. Here we go. Horse pokes it towards the White Bear bench. It's batted right back to him. Now Simonson has it, knocked away from him. He has to turn back for it. Horst lobs it back in. Good play. It just slows things down a bit. Rose coming up. There goes the goalkeeper. Rose into the zone. Knocked away from him. Klawitter on the ice. Make that Lawrence. Loose puck. Herta turns and missed it. Rose comes back for White Bear. 18 seconds left. Puck in neutral ice. Comes back sliding slowly. Simonson now up for Olsen. They'll have to hurry. They'll have to really hurry. Here's Olsen winding and firing. It's blocked. A rebound. They shoot. Oh! And that just missed off of Connolly's stick. There is the game. And Connolly just missed tying it with 2 seconds left.
What a chance he had right in the doorstep. And the goaltender must have just got his pad on it, just missed the far corner as a great effort by White Bear coming down the ice. Olsen taking that puck down, feeding it off to Connolly. Connolly breaking in, and just an outstanding chance for White Bear Lake. And this fellow, number 3, Tim Olsen, played a great game for White Bear today.
He was their best player.
Yes, he was, just a sophomore. And he had a great afternoon. But look at this effort. Road coming down, shot going over the side, and here comes Connolly. God, he just hit Musta's leg, goes right by the corner. And I think he thought it trickled in. He was starting to get a stick in the air.
Unbelievable finish.
Jeff Rose brought that puck up ice and with a great deal of speed forced it South St. Paul defense back. And boy, when that puck came over to Connolly, he had a look at the far corner and almost put it away.
South St. Paul will advance. They will be playing the Edina Hornets tomorrow night at 7 o'clock in the semifinals. Meanwhile, White Bear Lake will go to the consolation bracket, and they will play John Marshall tomorrow morning at 10 o'clock at Mariucci Arena.
What a thrilling last minute. White Bear Lake seeing their hopes to go on fade after a tremendous effort by Rose and then a great shot by Connolly, but South St. Paul emerges a victor on Nadeau's goal late in the third period. Some fine forechecking pressure by that line. A great centering pass to McClellan. South St. Paul coming out 3-2 win after Road shooting White Bear 27-14 here. The result in a victory for them.
Tough to lose like that, eh? Give them a lot of credit. They certainly played their hearts out here. They weren't supposed to be here. They did make it here and gave the Packers everything they could handle. Jeff Grayson is downstairs with a couple of the celebrating Packers.
All right, I'm here with David Bach. David, congratulations. 3 points for you today. What a game. Your thoughts on this one?
I don't know. I was so nervous when I got out there. It's my first time at the tournament. And I was just excited to play, and our team played great.
How tough was White Bear Lake? I mean, came in as a below 500 team, and they obviously played you guys right down to the last shot.
Yeah, they started out with some real tough teams. You know, when they top 10 in the state, they played, I think, their first seven games, and they've played great ever since. You know, we expected a great game out of them, and they gave us one.
Congratulations, David. We'll see you tomorrow night. We're going to bring in Clint Nadeau, who got the game-winning shot. Got the game-winning goal. Clint, congratulations. We're going to take a look at the game-winning shot to the monitor to your right if you want to describe the play.
All right. Well, number five, Ben McClellan got it somehow. I know he gets it. But he makes a good move on the kid here, and he sets me up in front of the net, and I had like four or five chances in the game, and finally one fell in for me.
Did the puck look like the size of a basketball at that point when it was right in front like
yeah,
that?
Yeah, I mean, it was just laying there. All I had to do was get it past the goalie, and finally I did. It took me like five chances.
What a back and forth game. I mean, that you scored two in the third period, they scored two in the second. Your thoughts overall on this one?
Yeah, well, anyone could have won this game. I mean, both teams just fought their hardest, and one team had to win. I mean, I'm happy it was us, but White Bear, I mean, they tried their hardest. They should deserve something for this.
Congratulations, Clint. We'll see you Friday. That is Clint Nadeau from South St. Paul. Got the winning goal against White Bear Lake in a great one. More game time on UPN 9 as quarterfinal Thursday continues.